But we're doing glory.
Yeah. I already talked to
him. Pakilagay sa upuan ko. This side. Good evening. Welcome to our Blessed Mother. Welcome to all of you. I'm very pleased that you could join us in this Mass of arrival for the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Antipolo. Greetings to all those who are following us on Facebook Live from the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, the Shrine of Our Lady, International Shrine of Our Lady of Antipolo. So we greet you with gratitude from St. John the Baptist. Also, those of just for tonight, we are live streaming this for our parish website. So greetings also to those who are joining us by live stream through St. John the Baptist. And I'd like to welcome into our midst the rector of the shrine, the cathedral shrine of Our Lady of Antipolo, Father Reynante Tolentino. He will be presiding tonight. Within the Mass, as we always do, we will have the novena to Our Mother Perpetual Help. So there's no rivalry between Antipolo and Perpetual Help, between Antipolo and Baclaran. We want to have a fitting arrival Mass for the Blessed Mother, and our parish is fortunate to be the permanent shrine for her, or the permanent place for her once we prepare our place for the Blessed Mother. So I'd like to invite you now to please stand, greet one another, welcome each other in the name of Christ. As we do, we will pray our Diocesan Eucharistic Revival prayer. Heavenly Father, in your loving mercy, you sent your Son Jesus Christ, anointed by the Spirit, to redeem the world through his Paschal mystery. The disciples on the road to Emmaus pleaded with the Lord, stay with us, promising to remain with his church and to nourish us as the bread of life and cup of salvation. Jesus left us the sacrament of salvation in the Eucharist. Stir up in our hearts a lively faith in Jesus' real, loving, and saving presence. And may the Eucharist become the pattern of our lives. As a pilgrim church, may be nourished and strengthened at the Eucharistic table, and so do unto others in love as you have loved us. Through the intercession of St. Joseph and St. Clare, may we remain in your love through the sacrament of your love. Amen.
To
At this Mass, we pray for the intentions of Bong Sanchez, Emmanuel Rudil, the Damaso family, and Robbie Ocampo, for the healing of Ben Cacao, Dennis Pua, Nick Arimbuanga, Nona Tolentino, Pinke Valenciano, Rosa Cardenas, Trinidad Bauson, Alex Gonzalez, Ranilo Trilliana, Eddie Tenco, Roberto de Guzman, Wilfredo Arcigono, Jedwane, Jesse Zamora, for the intention of Irene Banson,
For the repose of the souls of Deacon Joseph Huen, Jerome and Titus Pexon, Cesar Meneses, Bart Felipe Jr., Carlos Dahano, Ernesto Binluan, Ovedia Sevilla, Danilo Punsalan, Edario Tan, Vanji Navarro, Edario Tan, Timothy Vu, and Illuminada Danitaras. We pray for all these intentions at this Mass. Before we begin, I'd like to welcome into our midst a very generous priest who is the rector and of the shrine of the Cathedral of Our Lady of Antipolo, of the Diocese of Antipolo, in Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, but also the rector of the shrine. It is through his gift to us that we are here, and we are very happy to welcome Father Reinante Tolentino.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Let us gather and pray together in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as children of our Blessed Mother, we are gathered before her miraculous picture to honor her and to pray for all our needs. Unworthy children that we are, let us first all ask God's mercy and pardon. Merciful Father, you sent your divine Son to redeem us by his death and resurrection, to give us new life. By this you make us your children, to love one another in Christ. How many times in the past we have forgotten this divine dignity. We have sinned against our brothers and sisters. We have offended you. Merciful Father, forgive us. Repenting, conceal our sins. We ask for your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We bless you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you.
Let us pray. O God, who gladdened us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter and John were going up to the temple area for the 3 o'clock hour of prayer. And a man crippled from birth was carried and placed at the gate of the temple, called the Beautiful Gate, every day to beg alms from the people who entered the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms, but Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." He paid attention to them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "I have neither silver nor gold, but what I do have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, rise and walk." Then Peter took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles grew strong. He leaped up, stood, and walked around, and went into the temple with them, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the one who used to sit begging at the Beautiful Gate of the temple. And they were filled with amazement and astonishment at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus, and they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people. How our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Beginning then with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them, and it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread and said a blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?' So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, 'The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon.' Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Easter to all of you.
Happy Easter, Father.
Pati naman natin Happy Easter natin mga katabi.
Happy Easter.
Piling ko talagang buhay si Jesus sa St. John Baptist Parish na ito. Amen?
Amen.
with your parish priest, Monsignor, talagang si Kristo ay buhay. Imagine, today is Wednesday, halos mapuno yung ating simbahan. Palakpakan niyo naman mga sarili niyo. To Monsignor Wilfredo Manrique, the pastor of the Church of St. John the Baptist, to the community of Filipino Catholic of the Diocese of San Jose, to the parishioners of St. John the Baptist Church, and to all the pilgrims and devotees from the Philippines and from other places, greetings of peace from our Lord Jesus Christ through Mary, our Mother. On January 14, 1995, Pope St. John Paul II, on his address to the young people at Rizal Park, after the enthronement of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage for the World Youth Day, said this word, I quote, "The enthronement of Our Lady of Antipolo invites us to look to Mary to see how to respond to Jesus' call. First, she kept all things. Pondering them in her heart, she also went into haste to serve his cousin Elizabeth. Both attitudes are essential parts of our response to the Lord. Prayer and action. That is what the Church expects us of her young people. That is what I have come here to ask of you, Mary, Mother of the Church, our Mother, will help us to hear her divine Son." End of quote. Today, as we welcome the miraculous image of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage in your parish to be venerated by everyone, I want to re-echo those words of John Paul II. Look at our Mother, the Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, the Mother of Filipino people. In her life, she is the perfect example of responding to the call of the gospel for today, to pray without ceasing. She will be enthroned here so that we can see her and learn from her life, from her discipleship to her Son, Jesus Christ. Because of her love for God and for the Church, she can help us in a way worthy of God to continue our journey and being co-workers of spreading the gospel to everyone. Now that Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage is with us, let us trust her maternal care and intercession. Let us be wholeheartedly in love with the Blessed Mother. Filipinos are known to be Pueblo Amante de Maria, ang bayang sumisinta sa Mahal na Birhen, a people in love with Mary. As we constantly and persistently pray, let us ask her to always join us in prayer. This is what is expected in each and every one of us. With her, allow ourselves to be open to the will of God, ready to receive the immeasurable graces from Him like our Blessed Mother did. With her love, she allowed His grace to flow in accord with His perfect will. With this, she can lead us as we serve God and the Church, especially those who are in need of our aid. As we show her our love and devotion, may we also learn from her the perfect service that we can do to honor God and to be charitable to our neighbor, especially the poor. Let us respond like Mary, to obey, to pray, and to serve. As we welcome the Virgin of Antipolo, to our church, honor her, imitate her, and make her part of your life and family. I ask you to receive her as your mother, in so far as you are a member of Jesus' family. As we strive for obedience to the will of the Father in our life, we will also share in the blessings of his life. One of those great blessings is to share his mother, who is a great example of obedience, prayer, and service. May the image of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage bring us peace. We all pray for and lead us in this earthly journey towards her Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please stand. Novena prayer. Dear Mother of Perpetual Help, from the cross Jesus gave you to us for our mother, you are the kindest, the most loving of all mothers. Look tenderly on us, your children, as we now ask you to help us in all our needs, especially this one. Here we recall our own individual petitions and needs, while we also pray for the intentions of this Holy Mass. Those who have asked for our prayers, especially for healing, for thanksgiving, and also for the poor souls in purgatory. While you were on earth, dear Mother, you willingly shared in the sufferings of your Son, strengthened by your faith and confidence in the fatherly love of God, you accepted the mysterious designs of his will. We too have our crosses and trials. Sometimes they almost crush us to the ground. Dearest Mother, share with us your abundant faith and confidence in God. Make us aware that God never ceases to love us, that he answers all our prayers in the way that is best for us. Strengthen our hearts to carry the cross in the footsteps of your divine Son. Help us to realize that we who share the cross of Christ will certainly share his resurrection. Dearest Mother, as we worry about our own problems, let us not forget the needs of others. You always loved others so much. Help us to do the same. While praying for our own intentions and for the intentions of all here present at this novena, we earnestly ask you, our Mother, to help us comfort the sick and the dying, give hope to the poor and the unemployed, heal the brokenhearted, lighten the burden of the oppressed, teach justice to their oppressors, and bring back to God all those who have offended him. Dearest Mother, help us to avoid sin, which separates us from our Heavenly Father and from one another. Full of trust in you, we place ourselves under the mantle of your maternal protection and confidently hope for your powerful help. Amen. Prayer for the home. Mother of Perpetual Help, we choose you as queen of our homes. We ask you to bless all our families with your tender motherly love. May the sacrament of marriage bind husbands and wives so closely together that they will always be faithful to each other and love one another as Christ loves his church. We ask you to bless all parents. May they love and cherish the children whom God has entrusted to them. May they always give them the example of a truly Christian life. Help them to bring up their children in the love and fear of God. Bless all children, that they may love, honor, and obey their fathers and mothers. To your loving care, we especially entrust the youth of today.
Give us a sense of responsibility that we may do our part in making our home a haven of peace, like your own home at Nazareth. We take you as our model. Help us to grow daily in genuine love of God and neighbor, so that justice and peace may happily reign in the entire family of humankind. Amen. Holy Mary, Holy Virgin conceived without sin,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Our Mother of Perpetual Help,
pray for us.
We sinners call to you, that we may rejoice with you at Christ's victory over sin and death. That we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for everyone. That we may be more like our divine Lord as you were. That we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son Jesus. That we may fear losing God's friendship forever by unrepented sin. That we may seek Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance. That we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of daily life. That we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in moments of temptation. That we may realize the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist. That we may grow in the love of Christ and neighbor by frequent communion. That we may reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit. That we may strive to be true Christians by our loving concern for others. That we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously. That we may forgive from our heart those who have wronged us. That we may see the evil of seeking our own interests at the expense of others. That we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods. That we may share our talents with others for the good of the community. That we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service. To pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, Bishop Oscar Cantu, all bishops, the religious, and the clergy. That we may be blessed with an increase of priestly and religious vocations. That we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know him. That we may be aware of our dependence on God in the midst of human achievements. That we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father. That we may die at peace with Christ and our fellow men and women. That we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord. To pray that our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions. Holy Mary, help us in our needs. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience your perpetual help. Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to have recourse to her in all our needs.
Amen.
Act of consecration to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Mother of the Church, you are also our Mother of Perpetual Help. With hearts full of love for you, we consecrate ourselves to your Immaculate Hearts, so that we may be your devoted children. Obtain for us through sorrow for our sins and fidelity to all the promises of our baptism. We consecrate our minds and hearts to you, that we may always do the will of our Heavenly Father. We consecrate our lives to you, that we may love God better and live not for ourselves, but for Christ, your Son, and that we may see him and serve him in others. By this humble act of consecration, dear Mother of Perpetual Help, we pledge to model our lives on you, the perfect Christian, so that consecrated to you in life and in death, we may belong to your divine Son for all eternity. Let us be seated now to continue our celebration.
Oh,
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice which has redeemed the human race, and be pleased to accomplish in us salvation of mind and body through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the
Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and honored and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks and held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oscar our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honors is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Peace mo, Señor. Salamat po. Peace, Father. Peace, Father. Salamat po. Peace, Father. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Don't say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
For those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Blessed are you, heaven's women.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer to the Blessed Mother.
We fly to the protection of Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Prayer to Saint Michael.
Saint
Michael, Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Thanksgiving prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, truly present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. Thus please the Father, that in you all his fullness should dwell, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we be truly sorry for our sins and do penance for them. Through you we thank the Eternal Father for the gifts of life. He has created all the wonderful things of this world for us. May we learn to use them well, so that through them we may grow in love for him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of his love, to save us and all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own mother, to be our mother of perpetual help. May the countless favors we have received through her intercession, especially through the novena, inspire us to greater confidence in God's loving mercy and her perpetual help. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God and persevere in love. To the most holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be honor, glory, and thanksgiving forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, you bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows in order to show us clearly the value of human weakness and patience. Graciously hear our prayers for the sick. Grant that those who are weighed down with pain and other afflictions of illness may realize that they are among the chosen ones whom you call blessed. Help them to understand that they are united with you in your sufferings for the salvation of the world. Amen. Please be seated. One of the things that I learned from my father, which I appreciate very much, was when he said to me,
pag mabait sa iyong tao, dapat maging mabait ka rin. Okay. And the Diocese of Antipolo, the International Shrine of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, has been very good to the Diocese of San Jose. We announced the past few Sundays that it was at the pilgrimage of Bishop Cantu and Filipino priests and also some lay people who went to Antipolo, the Shrine of Antipolo in January of 2023. And I believe one of the intentions was to accompany the Diocese of San Jose as we were preparing for the Synod, the Diocesan Synod. And it was then that they met the rector, Father Nante Tolentino, who graciously invited us to send a request to the Bishop of Antipolo for a statue of the Blessed Mother, a replica. It's the same size and the same height, the same everything. The clothes that she's wearing today was worn by the original statue in Antipolo, and we have been graciously been given that the clothes for the Blessed Mother. So the long and short of it, we would like to gift this shrine from the goodness of our hearts. So I am proposing a second collection this evening as our gift to the shrine in Antipolo in appreciation for the gift of the Blessed Mother to us. It is our love offering to her. So thank you for your generosity. Thank you very much. Pag kay Mama Mary, tumatayo kayong lahat, ha? I am very pleased and amused that we have 5 images of the Blessed Mother tonight. We have our Mother of Perpetual Helper, we have our Lady of Peace in Good Voyage, we have the Mater Dolorosa, we have Our Lady of Fatima at the back. And finally, we have the Sweetheart of Mary, St. Joseph. Sweetheart, joke. Sino bang sweetheart ni Mama Mary? This is St. Joseph. I have one quick announcement. From St. John the Baptist, this is a mass of arrival for the Blessed Mother. The official mass of welcome for her will be presided by Bishop Cantu at Our Lady of Peace. Okay, Our Lady of Peace Church on Tuesday, April 16th at 7 p.m. So we invite you to that official mass for the Blessed Mother, for the whole diocese. This is our welcome. We were just privileged, and Father Nante has been generous to agree to celebrate and entrust this statue to us. Father Nante will be leaving for Southern California to deliver another image of the Blessed of Our Lady of Antipolo to St. Catherine of Siena Parish in Reseda, in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. So, and from there, I think you're going back to the Philippines. Okay. So we appreciate the huge effort that Father Nante has expended for us, and also his able assistants, Noel Reyes Ayo Nasanka. Okay, thank you for accompanying the Blessed Mother. He put together the image and the structure on which she stands, and also the andas, the carrier. So we thank you from the bottom of our heart here at St. John. She will leave St. John on Monday, the 15th, I think, the 15th. And we will bring her to Our Lady of Peace, and then she will stay at Our Lady of Peace. What the Filipino priests have proposed is every month she will go and visit the different parishes in the diocese for the next 12, 15 months. And then finally, when our shrine is ready in June of 2025, during our fiesta, and also during the International Jubilee Year, she will find her home permanently here at St. John. So make sure, as Father Nante said, be, as you are devotees of the Blessed Mother, to accompany her and also welcome her into your hearts and into your home and into your parishes. We will be posting the list of the sequence of the parishes as she will visit during the next 15 to 16 months. So once again, thank you, Father Nante. Thank you so much. Maraming maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat din po kay Monsignor Willie Manrique, sa mga kapatid ng mga pare, at sa inyo pong lahat. Maraming salamat din po. Tatlo po yung kasama ko dito na from the Philippines. Yung aming international camarero, si Noel Reyes T-Boy. Palakpan natin si Brother T-Boy. Si Tito Jun Figueroa, yung aming social communication.
Thank you.
At yung pong pinakagwapong anak ni T-Boy, si Momon. Darito rin po yung mga pamilya ni T-Boy, mga anak niya na mga cute, magaganda, kapatid niya si Doyet, kasi dito po sila sa San Jose nakatira. Taga rito po sila. Tatlong beses na ako sa US, doon po ako tumitira sa kanila. Last March 25, 2023, dineclare ni Pope Francis yung ating Antipolo Cathedral at National Shrine as first international shrine in the Philippines and in Southeast Asia. Yung solemn declaration po niya ay last January 26. It was attended by 85 bishops plus the papal nuncio. Tapos noong February 26, pinadala ni Pope Francis yung kanyang personal gift dun sa biro ng Antipolo, yung golden rose o rosa de oro na binibigay ng Pope sa isang image. Kaya sa Philippines at sa buong Southeast Asia, siya pa lang ang binibigyan ng golden rose ng Santo Papa, si Pope Francis. Kaya palakpakan natin ng mga libero. Diocese of Antipolo, Antipolo Cathedral, the International Sign of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, Immaculate Conception Parish, Certificate of Donation and Recognition. This is to certify that this image of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, Virgen of Antipolo, at St. John the Baptist Church, Diocese of San Jose in Milpitas, California, USA, is one of the recognized replicas of the 17th century wooden image of the Blessed Virgin Mary, venerated in our country and in the International Sign of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, Cathedral of the Roman Catholic Diocese of Antipolo, Antipolo City, Philippines, whose solemnity is celebrated every first Tuesday of May. This is carved in wood by Mr. Ian Vicente under the directive of the Cathedral and Shrine Rector, Reverend Father Inantio Tolentino. This image was given during the Welcome Mass on third day of April 2024 and received by Reverend Monsignor Wilfredo Manrique, pastor of St. John the Baptist Church. The receiving parish is thus entrusted to promote the devotion to Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage within the Diocese of San Jose and its respective state through pilgrim image, visits, and pilgrimages. May this image of Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage be the sign that the Blessed Mother is with us in our pilgrimage of faith into her Son, Jesus Christ, in fulfilling our mission as a pilgrim church. Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, Virgen of Antipolo, Mother of the Filipino people, pray for us. Signed, yours truly, Shrine Rector. Signed, Most Reverend Ruperto C. Santos Didi, Bishop of Antipolo.
Thank you. Thank you, Father Nante. As the prophet Simeon said in the gospel, now, O Lord, you can dismiss your servant. I've seen the salvation. Thank you very much for this certificate of donation. I'd also want to thank the visiting priest who joined us. Father Tito Cartagenas is the vicar for Filipino Ministry of the Diocese of San Jose. Father Anthony Uitinco is parochial vicar at St. Lawrence the Martyr in Santa Clara. At the back, we have Father Jeff Fernandez, who is the pastor of Queen of Apostles in San Jose. And Father Victor Trinidad, who is the parochial vicar at St. Clair in Santa Clara. So thank you for your presence with us. To all our ministers and to all those who have assisted us in this preparation, and to all of you who are joining us both here at St. John's Church and also live stream across the digital world, thank you for your presence and our admiration for the Blessed Mother. Viva la Virgen de Antipolo!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen de Antipolo!
Viva!
Viva la Virgen de Antipolo!
Viva!
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Mother of Mercy.